Susan Roberti, and look where we're at. We're at the Pet Expo. I can't believe it. I'm so excited. Behind me, there are some of the most beautiful, beautiful poodles and grooming. And it's part of the fun of having a dog. As you all know, that was my life for many, many years, was grooming. I'm just so excited to be here. We're going to walk around. But before I get started, I want to say thank you to my camera person. Thank you, Erin. She's the girl that brings me down here all the time. We walk around together. She puts up with me, and we do a wonderful show, and she's a volunteer, and I'm a volunteer, and like always, BPTV is a wonderful corner. So don't forget about us, and this is the kind of wonderful thing that you can do. If you're a guy, you can go to a car show and talk about cars. So, we're going to get started, and we're going to see some of these poodles over here, but they're insane colors. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Then we're going to walk around and see if we can find the bird guy and different kind of foods, and I'm just so excited. So welcome to the Expo.
Chris Roosh, I'm the commander of Allegheny Mountain Rescue Group.
The commander, what do you do?
I lead the search and rescue team, and our search and rescue team looks for lost and missing people, and we use search dogs to do that.
Now, you get in some really stupid places.
We do some interesting things, so we look for Alzheimer's patients, autistic children, also missing hunters, and even crime victims. So we do a little bit of everything, kind of go everywhere. We also do cave rescue and cliff rescue. We definitely get into some interesting places. I've been doing this for about 16 years, and I started out with an outdoor background, hiking, camping, rock climbing, that kind of stuff. And from there, I moved into how can I use those skills to help other people. We have about 35 volunteers and about 10 dogs, and we have some of our search and rescue dogs are here with us. This is Oakley, and she's a border collie, and she's what we call an air scent dog. She'll go and search a large area, 80 acres, 120 acres, and look for any person who's in that area.
She can pick it up.
She can pick it up that far. It's kind of like Lassie. She'll go in and search the area. She'll work off-leash independently, working with her handler. And when she finds a person, she'll go back to her handler and let her know that she found it. She'll bark, let them know, and then lead them back to the person so we can help them. They're amazing. We also have trailing dogs that will not search large areas, but they'll follow the specific scent and track a person. So if somebody goes missing from their house, like an autistic child wanders away, we can pick up their scent at their house and follow them. And then we'll also do more forensic work, working with the police and crime scenes and detail scent work.
Well, I thank you so much for everything that you do.
Thank you, and thank you for the opportunity to share a little information about Allegheny Mountain Rescue Group.
Carla Mayer. I publish Pet Connections magazine. Oh yes, people love telling stories about their pets. We're also a free local resource. We provide directories, and we also support local organizations with free articles and sponsor events.
So how did you get started?
Well, I used to be a veterinary technician for years, and then I founded the magazine in 2012. Kind of fourth year anniversary. Yes. Yeah. We also publish in Central Ohio as well.
Wow. Wow. Well, I thank you so much for all the work.
Thank you.
And I'll get in touch with you when you come down. And Jeff,
I certainly would love to.
Well, Jeff,
good.
Yeah.
All right.
Jeff,
pause.
Yep.
Oh, he's trying. It's early on, guys. Give him a big round of applause for my friend here, baby.
And I'll invite you up and we can sit and talk on the Tailwaggers. Thank you, dear.
Thank you.
We're going to start with just a little bit of healing. We'll go through healing. Change of positions in a little woods. Little woods is just a scent discrimination exercise. I have a little piece of little wood dowel. I have to put my odor on it. I have to set it down. Or I should have the pieces on there. You can only bring back the piece that I see there. And then we'll go through our bike work, and we'll be free events in the bike work, and it's my favorite.
Here. once I make a sale, if it's a certain need out there in that rescue, or I have rescues and shelters that I work with on a monthly basis that I send to. People are so happy to be able to support there. It just works for them. I don't know if you noticed, but my mom does quilting, and I used to love putting fabrics together with her to make things, and I think that came out in my art digitally. It is a myth. Even those known as swimming dogs labs, they sometimes just don't get the natural motion of it. Again, you can teach most of them to do it, but it is a myth.
They're all set, ready to go. Audience, some of us have fun. Count this down for Laura. She's going to need you out there. So let's get real wild. Help her out. We'll count down. Let's go. 3, 2.
It really is. It's very popular in Europe. It's very popular in the western part of the United States, and it's starting to make its way to Florida. My dog is a dock jumper. She dogs with dock dogs, and she got injured about 4 years ago, and that's kind of how we got started. We had to travel into Ohio, round trip, 3.5 hours every other day.
See what people do for their dog,
yes? So we are the only one in the tri-state area within a 3-hour radius. And again, you know, we can pretty much work with any dog. Your vet would have to sign off on your dog participating. It's extremely high cardio for them. So for 5 minutes in a pool, it's almost like a 10-mile run to a person. So we want to make sure that they're in the right posture. If they were never overweight, we do obesity, so we get them in the pool and get them moving. You know, it's just like us. If you're overweight, you hurt, and then you tend to stop moving. In the pool, it's 100% weightless environment, so it's great for overweight dogs. We actually have a dog that comes. He was a therapy dog and had a condition where they had to put him on steroids, and he gained almost 50 pounds. And he comes for weight management, and he's doing wonderful. He chased a squirrel for the first time the other day, as owners said. So it's really rewarding. We're very excited to be in this area to bring this type of service. So if you look us up at www.lifeforcek9.com, we're on Facebook as well. We'd love to hear from everybody. And
all right, my friend, how are you doing today?
Work with them to where we can possibly avoid surgery. We'll work with their vet and their surgeon. It is happening a lot. And, you know, surgery isn't always the only option. We can work with them and see if we can build those muscles. And a lot of times people think it's for older dogs only, and it's really not. If you start to build those muscles on your younger dogs and get them into shape, you will see less of the ACL tear and hip dysplasia and the elbow dysplasia than ever seen in a lot of our dogs.
you go, don't go yet. Alright, audience, Dominic is all set. We need a super loud kiss down for him as well. So let's make you feel special. Let's have some fun. Here we go. Three, two,
absolutely,
one.
Call us if you have any questions. We'd love to meet everybody.
Oh, Jason's looking for that long road.
Thank you very much. Nice to meet you.
We're
going to
try
to
get it.
And surgery technician at Pittsburgh Veterinary Specialty and Emergency Center.
Wow, I bet you that is so overwhelming sometimes. It's so wonderful sometimes.
Absolutely. It can be very challenging and stressful, but when we have the good, yes, the outcomes, taking care of our patients and giving them the best care that we can makes the day better. Pittsburgh Veterinary Specialty and Emergency Center. We're located on Camp Horn Road, just outside of Pittsburgh, along 279.
And we're not going to be building a new one anywhere?
We will be building a new facility in Washington. We're looking to open up this summer of 2017.
Good, because I
appreciate that. Center, and we also offer referrals for the specialties. We have 13 different specialties in our hospital with all board certified veterinarians.
Now, what is the blood?
I'm sorry? The blood donor? Lauren is actually more familiar with our blood donor program. Her own dog, Mocha, donates blood for our clinic.
What does this do? I mean, what kind of dog? What do you do?
We have guidelines for dogs that are available to donate. They have to be at least 50 pounds, and they can donate them between ages 1 and 7. And typically, they donate every 2 to 3 months.
And their blood is good for any dog?
No. Dogs have 11 different types of blood, but it's the same as humans. There are universal donors as well. So once they come in for their initial screening, we decide what their blood type is, and then that's how we use it.
So if somebody would like to volunteer?
Yes.
To come down there and have their dog blood, they can come down and talk to you about that?
They can start by visiting our website, pbs-ac.com, and they can email and set up an initial screening. We do all of our blood donations and screenings on Saturdays. So you would bring your dog in for initial screening. We would take blood work, make sure they're healthy and everything's okay. It takes 2 to 3 weeks to get the results, and then we would let you know at that point.
And I bet you're busy all the time. I mean, this is me.
Yes, we do. Yeah. We do over 600 blood transfusions a year, typically. And one dog donated blood can save up to 4 lives, depending on how we use the blood, if it's whole blood, plasma, or spin down.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. I'm going to take one of these.
Please.
And I thank you so very much.
Thank you.
And what is your name?
My name is Cindy Garfold. I'm the executive director of Western Pennsylvania Search and Rescue Development Center.
And what does that do? That's a big name.
It is a very big name. And we develop the safety programs for the at-risk population that wanders. The autism, the Alzheimer's, dementia, people with Down syndrome. We actually have the equipment here today that we use to locate them when they go missing. We use dogs, we use equipment, we use tools that bring them home safely.
Now, does that a child with autism would have to wear something so that the dog could hear it or search for it?
The dog uses the scent. The child wears what we have there is a transmitter that goes, wears it as a wristwatch or on his leg if they're younger, that we will use the receiver to listen for. If the child or the person gets separated from the transmitter, the dogs are trained to work as the last scent forward. It is a labor of love. We've been doing it for 14 years and we enjoy it. It is a labor of love, and today we're here because we have opened up our agility center to the public so that the dogs can see what our dogs go through in training. We have a tunnel, a wobble board.
Now, do you have volunteers with people that have dogs that you volunteer to help you?
Yes, ma'am. Our volunteers not only come from the public sector, but they come from the emergency sector also. We have law enforcement working with us, fire, EMS people working with us, and they donate their time to learn more about the special need population. Thank you for asking about us.
But it really must warm your heart when you find someone.
It does. We would like to bring them home safely. Again, we've been doing this 14 years, and we've all been trained on it, certified on it, and our organization just became certified as a PA, Department of Human Service Provider, so we're very happy.
Wow, congratulations. That was a lot of work.
It is a lot of work.
Well, good. Maybe someday you could spend some time and come up to the station in Bethel, and we could sit and just talk.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because let's talk Tailwaggers. I just like to sit and talk with people and, you know, find out what they're doing.
We would love to talk about our organization.
Good. So I'll get a card and I'll give you a call.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sweetheart. I
love you. You too.
Your name is?
My name is Rich.
And what is this interesting thing?
This is called the tether tug. So basically, it's a outdoor tether tug toy. So how it works is you stake this into your ground in your yard or some grassy area, and then you plug this in, and then it's ready to go. So instead of playing tug of war with your dog, you're able to just sit back, relax, and let your dog do all the work. So depending on the size of your dog, right, I think the first thought that comes to people's minds is your dog's going to rip it out of the ground, especially if you have a large dog. So the tether tug actually comes in a variety of different sizes and durability depending on the weight of your dog. So we have the medium size here for a small guy up to 35 pounds. This works pretty effectively. You can see here you can clip off or clip on your dog's favorite toy. This comes with the rope here. Some people tie a ball at the end, it's a ball that your dog may be already used to chewing, that type of thing. So
that is absolutely
isn't
precious.
It? Yeah.
Good idea.
Yeah, great.
I like it.
Yep.
I hope you do well. I really do.
I think you will.
Well, it's that time. We have to say goodbye, and it could not end more perfectly than with Santa Claus. I would like to wish you all a wonderful new year, a Merry Christmas. Thank you for the whole year, because we sure did have a lot of wonderful shows. And if you know anybody that would like to be on Let's Talk Tailwaggers, please let me know. I want to remind you of Pets for Vets, U.S. Vets. Send your money to the Washington Area Humane Society. I want to say I love you. And thanks for all the tailwaggers. Roberti, producer and talk show host of Let's Talk Tailwaggers. This is a wonderful time of the year. Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's. I would like to say thank you to all of you. When I see you out and about in the stores, you tell me such wonderful, sad, happy, unbelievable stories about your pets, and it really warms my heart. I'd like to say thank you to my guests that gave up their time to come to Let's Talk Tailwaggers. I hope you enjoyed them. I know I did. Through the years, I have asked you to send sheets, towels, blankets to the Humane Societies. I thank you for that. With all that, you are helping to keep pets warm. You are keeping the puppies warm and the new mothers, and I thank you for that. I know you have heard me talk about pets for U.S. vets. The last few years, me and you have gotten over 280 best friends their homes. They thank you. A broken heart for a broken heart makes a whole heart. I pray your Thanksgiving is sweet. I pray that Christmas is blessed with the love of your family. The new year is safe and full of joy for all. Do not cry. God bless you. Most of all, thank you from the Tailwaggers. Merry Christmas. God bless. From Susan Roberti.